Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up.
At the end of the day, there's a lot of companies out there.
Let's say you need 5 million product, I'd take care of that.
We're going to be immediately raising money.
Let us decide if we think it's compelling enough.
If the pitch fails...
You choke so easily.
Oh, he's breaking the cardinal rule of pitching.
Okay, send him down.
Going down.
No!
But if the pitch is successful...
Good pitch.
Okay, open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Boom, mother...
And it's not just up to the judges. Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch lets you, the viewer, get in on the action through crowdfunding.
You got a deal.
Yeah. Nice job.
Is the next billion-dollar idea on its way up? This is... Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
Okay, you guys ready to hear the pitch?
Absolutely.
Yep.
I'm ready to make some money.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hey, I'm Steve with Los Caídos, and we honor the fallen and help their families by selling cigars and giving a dollar back on every cigar sold to charity. I'm freezing. I'll get it. Man, cigar to charity. We launched in 16 with 500 boxes, and they quickly sold out to individuals, brick and mortars, and largest online cigar retailer in the world across 11 states. Very little ad spend. We have excellent product market fit, 71% margin, great team, very low monthly burn. Cigars in America are the largest market in the industry, $8 billion, and one of the oldest industries in America. But cigars for us are only the beginning. What I love being about here is David Meltzer writes about making money, having fun, and helping others by connecting to goodness. That's Los Caídos. He also talks about the universe. And if you think about the universe,
five.
Someone read
totally
your book.
Four, this.
Three.
I'm letting
two,
him through. He read my
one.
Book.
Please. David, can I have another chance, please?
Did he just abort his own mission?
You gotta open the door, you
No!
He needs a cigar.
Listen, every entrepreneur is going to have twists and turns and ups and downs, and they got to fight through.
Is this a racing joke?
No.
Okay.
He needs to know you never quit.
I like that he cared.
He did care, and he thanked us.
The industry itself isn't even interesting to me. He could have nailed the pitch, and I'm not sure we'd want to open the doors, so.
I agree.
Don't confuse effort with accomplishment.
Whoa, I think we end on that note. Why don't you send him down?
Truth hurts sometimes. All right, send him down.
Going down.
It's not meant to be at this time. Thank you, everybody, for the opportunity. I choked, and I apologize for you. There's no other way to say it. It's like being at the free throw line to win the game. I choked. No, nothing else about it.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Kristen Voss, and I am the owner and creator of K-Voss NYC, a certified vegan and organic skincare line. On an average, we use about 10 products a day, and there are over 574 chemicals in those products alone. Your skin acts more as a sponge than a barrier, and what you put on it actually goes into your bloodstream faster than if you ate it. Even in this very saturated market, there's still a demand, especially for what my company has to offer. No other brand is like mine. It's been my goal and purpose to create a line of products that deliver only healthy and effective ingredients while maintaining affordability. I started my business in my kitchen in New York City. After reading the labels on all the products I was using, I was struck at how many of them contained unhealthy and cancer-causing ingredients. What I developed, I knew I had to share. The amazing news is, in the first year of business, I secured a deal with the biggest beauty subscription box for 202,000 units of one of my lip balms. And that ran so well that we are running an additional time for an extra 303,000 units in 2 months. At this point, I have more of a demand for my product than what I can meet alone.
Two, one, time's up.
Well, there's no ask, right?
So. No.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a really hard space, this whole...
This is an emerging space, though. I mean, I remember when I was younger, I'm like, who cares about organic? And now I'm like, I'm going to die if I don't eat organic, so...
Yeah, no, that's true.
I've seen tons of companies that are taking the organic, so I would want to understand what's unique.
They hated me.
For me, bottom line is she has orders and needs to fulfill them.
Yeah.
Like, I'm there's straight business, right?
Let's give her the opportunity.
Yeah, I support opening doors.
Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yay!
Yes.
Good job.
I have have something for each of you. Can I give it to you?
Oh, it's a sample.
Love it. You get three because you're a girl. I don't think you guys need lip balms, do you?
No, we're all good.
That's the number one recipe that I make, Nourish Body Lotion. There's less than seven ingredients in everything that I make.
What was your revenues last year?
About 200,000.
And what are you asking for?
I would love to be able to secure a deal for 10% for 50,000.
You know, at the end of the day, there's a lot of companies out there that do a lot of the same things. What's your story?
I was raised by a single mom, and she had cancer when I was younger. She had a bunch of skin grafts done, and it really affected the way she felt about herself and the way she presented herself. I actually recently just went through getting over skin cancer myself. Literally every single thing that you put on your skin goes into your bloodstream. I decided that I wanted to make something that was truly unique because a lot of people start out a business that have money and have chemists doing it for them, and it's not made with the intention of like love and trying to actually heal something. And that's what this is.
What would you do with the 50,000? Why do you need it?
So I am completely comfortable making up to 10 or 20,000 units. I can't make a million units in my kitchen. There are a couple of deals that I actually have had to turn away because I haven't had the money to source manufacturers for them.
What are your margins right now?
Depending on the product.
Yeah.
For instance, the lotion. The 4-ounce jar is $24. I make about $22 on that.
Wait, say that again?
I sell it for $24.
And you make $22?
Yes.
I'd say those are pretty decent margins.
Would you be interested in giving up more of your company if we gave debt financing with it?
By that we mean, you know, we could help support your purchase orders.
My only thought here is $50,000, even with some, is nothing. We're going to be immediately almost raising money after the $50,000.
That's fine if they have POs.
Here's my suggestion. I think if we go with 50, and I understand what Peter's saying, we are going to have to raise more money. But if we can have the first right of refusal on that additional raise, then I think it's a decent launch.
I would support that.
Danica?
I think that you've already proved yourself, obviously, with the fact that you have these orders. I mean, that's impressive.
So our offer is $50,000 for 20% in equity, plus we'll provide debt financing for every credible PO that you have, and then we want the first option for future financing.
Okay. I'm in.
All right.
I'm gonna start crying.
As you guys know, I mean, in businesses, you have to be online. You have to have a presence. So on behalf of GoDaddy, we'd like to offer you $10,000, as well as two different packages to take your online presence to the next level. So one is $400 value. You can build it yourself. Or an $1,800 value where you can use one of GoDaddy's online experts to help you do that. So $10,000 as well as your online presence being elevated by GoDaddy with their help. So I really think this is something that you could use to take you to the next level.
Oh, thank you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations.
I just got a deal. The entire market is moving towards natural and organic products. It's a huge marketplace, and I'd like to have a much bigger part of it.
Let's hear the next pitch.
Let's do it.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Viviana.
And I'm Elvis.
Having two young daughters, we know firsthand their artistic skills in making a mess on floors.
And truthfully, cleaning floors has never been practical, efficient, or fun.
Traditional sweeping brooms require a lot of muscle and spread billions of dirty microparticles back into the air.
Microfiber dust mops cut the cleaning time in half and possess the remarkable ability to trap nasty dust particles in the fibers.
But you still need other tools to pick up debris from the floor, and even then, you're left with a filthy pad that requires to be brushed off or washed.
And those disposable wet and dry mop pads that dominate the market? Convenient, yes, but what a waste. That's why we invented the world's most practical and convenient floor cleaning system to date, Duet.
A microfiber dust mop that transforms into a sweeping broom. Now you can quickly and efficiently dust mop your floors while picking up debris as you go.
But this is no ordinary dustpan. Ours has a unique self-cleaning feature, ensuring you'll never have to touch a dirty pad again.
Time's up.
Not a good pitch, because we didn't get much information.
They did nothing that was compelling for us to want to open that door.
There may be something interesting, but if you can't get through the 60-second pitch, then I'm not sure how we're supposed to take that leap.
And there was no information on
Zero.
What their business looks like right now, which is the biggest thing. Like, do you have a start or not?
This is a business show.
There's not enough there.
Yeah.
I'm shaking.
I'm gonna have to pass.
Oh my God. Okay, send him down.
Going down.
At the end of the day, it was not a very good pitch. It was something where they need to be compelling enough for us to open the door, and I just didn't feel it.
I think more than compelling, just informative.
I feel okay about this. Still sad, though.
1 minute seemed like 2 seconds in there, so, you know, we kind of blew it there, but it's all good.
It's a good experience.
Yes, absolutely.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
As a kid, there's nothing quite as sweet or daring as sneaking bites of cookie dough when mom's not looking. Truth is, we never quite grow out of that habit of eating raw cookie dough, but it comes with great risk. That risk became a reality in 2009 when a big food company had to recall all of their cookie dough because nearly 80 people ended up in the hospital with E. coli. As an avid cookie dough eater and a Le Cordon Bleu trained pastry chef, this was my light bulb moment. Hi, I'm Ronna Lestian, and I am the CEO and founder of Edible Cookie Dough. Edible is the first and only premium, 100% safe to eat cookie dough that has a delicious taste, a clean label, and it tastes straight from the mixing bowl. So we launched in late 2014 as a digital native brand, and we've sold nearly $1.5 million of cookie dough direct to consumer. And in the last 6 months, we've grown from 50 to 600 stores, mostly on the West Coast. We are looking to raise $1 million.
Time's up.
She hit all the high points here, and she's done $1.5 million in revenue, already has retail distribution.
She's got amazing credentials. She's exceptionally likable. We should
definitely
talk to her.
The question I have is it nutritious? She's a pastry chef, so we should trust her, right?
I don't think there's a question what we should do.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yay! I'm so excited!
Welcome.
Hi.
Welcome.
I have a treat for each of you.
These samples had nothing to do with us opening the door, by the way.
Exactly.
So don't eat cookie dough.
Right, don't eat cookie
dough.
You risk getting salmonella from the raw egg, E. coli from the raw flour.
What makes yours E. coli proof?
Because we use a pasteurized flour and there's no raw egg.
Do you have to refrigerate this?
It can be ambient for 3 weeks. In the fridge 6 months.
And how long in the freezer?
1 year.
Wow.
It's delicious.
It's delicious.
Okay, so let's talk about some numbers. You're asking for $1 million. What are you going to do with $1 million? How are you valuing the company?
We are valuing the company at $5 million.
$1 million for 20% of your company?
Mm-hmm. We are mainly using it to grow our team. I've been doing this pretty much myself with a small team in our kitchen. We do all of our own manufacturing and also marketing spend so that we can grow this category as it is a brand new category.
Have you raised money before?
So we raised a friends and family round, $300,000.
At what valuation?
At a $3
million. My feeling is that the $3 million valuation is probably a little premature. So I'd be supportive of doing something back at the $3 million round.
Well, I guess to me the key question is, put valuation aside, mm-hmm. what dollar amount do you need today to be able to scale this business to the next level? That's the key number.
So we're raising a seed round at $1 million to take us through the next 16 to 18 months.
And do you have other money committed on that $1 million seed round?
Yes.
Okay, so this is an important piece of information.
Yes. Good question.
So how much of the million has ultimately been committed and or funded?
All of our friends and family who are looking to re-up.
Okay.
And we have another investor who we're very close in our negotiations to about $250,000 to $300,000.
So you're looking for an additional $500,000, give or take.
Right.
Out of $1 million seed
yes,
round.
Yes, exactly.
And they have no problem with the valuation of $5 million?
We're still discussing valuation.
So you haven't set the valuation on this round yet?
Correct.
All right, guys, what do you want to do?
I'm not sure we're in a position to give you an answer until we actually know what the valuation's going to be.
Right.
You've heard from us now that we're much more comfortable back at this $3 million level.
Mm-hmm.
If you're in that range, then I think this group might be interested.
Mm-hmm. I agree
Absolutely.
With that.
So we leave it there, and then you can come back to us and let us know how the round is coming together.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a timeline, or is it up to my timeline?
Your timeline.
My timeline.
You tell us
okay.
what you have, yeah.
Great.
As quickly as possible.
Yes, for me too. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
We have a group of four very intelligent, very experienced, interested investors, and that's really, really valuable.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
My name is Jack McNamara, and I am the lone wolf behind Drink True. I'm seeking $300,000 in convertible debt at a $5 million price cap in order to launch new SKUs, build an awesome team, and fund marketing support for major retailers. I'm a washed-up pro hockey player, and I noticed that at every level, from peewees to the pros, supplements flooded our locker rooms, and I just couldn't understand why elite athletes who train three times a day eating paleo, keto diets, were sucking down artificial energy shots and sugary sports drinks. It was then that I decided to hang up those beautiful skates in exchange for the sexy life of surfing couches and living in a gym to launch True Energy. Powered by green tea, True Energy is infused with 10 vitamins, antioxidants, and electrolytes from coconut water. And it's non-GMO and vegan. Whether you're an elite athlete, weekend warrior, True will help you dominate your day from the weight room to the boardroom. So open up those doors.
He has a great personality.
Good pitch.
You can go to people and distribution points and bring him with, and they'll be like, I like this guy.
Good salesman for that product.
I agree, but there's so many like drink companies too. Like, you know what I mean?
It's all about distribution too here.
He's looking for $300,000, I'm guessing, on a convertible note with a $5 million cap. So this is not an inexpensive thing.
He's a great guy, but I can't invest on emotion. I'd hire him as a sales rep for your wine company.
Right.
That guy could sell your wine.
I mean, candidly, I'm not a big fan of the space that he's about to be entering into right now.
Yeah, I'm out. I don't think we should open the doors.
I concur.
Okay, send him down.
Going down.
It sucks.
It's very similar to a playoff game. I mean, you have to bring your A game, and I mean, maybe it wasn't an A+, but I thought I played well today. I'll leave my cards, and if anyone changes their mind, I'll be available.
To support any of these entrepreneurs through crowdfunding, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
I feel like I should say, like, namaste.
This is the mellow Danica.
I'm curious about this one.
I have to admit, sort of boring.
Look what I got you. And you'd be like,
How embarrassing.
To apply for season 3, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.